Hello everybody, and welcome to my spiritual wellness vlog. My name is which means Serafina Girly Motto in the sacred spiritual language. As this is a transcendental module, some of you beginners might feel a bit disorientated. So may I suggest you reach out to someone wearing natural fibers, and that will help to ground you. Spiritual avatars are swathed in draped cashmere. Colour-wise, choose between bone, clunch, mizzle, or plummet. To be an avatar, you have to be able to prove that you can fly, die, and then come back as an ancient Tibetan Lama child or a praying mantis. I personally recommend 4 hours of Ashtanga yoga every day, preferably before dawn. But a word of warning, never, ever, ever attempt any yoga posture unless you're in full Lululemon. And always sit at the very, very front of the class. That way, everybody will be able to see just how spiritual you really are. RSPs, or really spiritual people, deem it auspicious to photograph themselves performing elaborate yoga postures whilst balancing between two rocks in spiritual countries such as Goa, Ibiza, and the Maldives, whilst novices get to photograph their daily colonic legacy and stick it on their Instagram page until they've achieved the correct spiritual shape. And now, a word on spiritual communication. The best listening stance is to put your head on the side like this. That way, the person that you're talking to will think you're really interested in whatever it is they're talking about. Whilst you're talking, offer them a wan smile, coupled with the nod of wisdom. Then, contort your face into the gown of compassion, whilst gently cupping their cheek, just to show them how concerned you are about their drink problem. Do spiritual people eat? Well, spiritual dart comes in liquid form and tastes of fish. Namaste. Delicious. Choose from Berylina, chlorella, maca, chaga, yucca, lucuma, cambu cambu, breath. Finally, toxins. Toxins are everywhere, in your food, in the curtains, they're even in your friend's newborn baby's eyes, and there's nothing you can do about them, nothing, because they're everywhere. All you can do is sit in the corner, exploring a raisin, mindfully. A raisin, rather than a revel. Do you know about these revels? Well, they're full of toxins. Awash with E numbers. E204, E307, E5663, they're everywhere. And you can't get rid of them, because everywhere you go, they bizarre. I bet that's an orange cream. They're the worst. Oh no, it's not. I'm sure that one is. Well, I'll just sample to show you what I mean. Easy it is for toxins to affect your mood. That's why these are going in the bin, I'm afraid. Anyway, what were we saying? Toxins. I've just got to go and rinse out my moonbeam sprout tray. Just do that now. So goodbye. Bye.